வித் எ கேப்ஷன், விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரிப்பது. விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரிப்பது. ட்ரூலி இட்ஸ் அ ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் வேல்யூ. நாட் ஓன்லி இட்ஸ் அ ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் வேல்யூ, இட் கோஸ் வெரி மச் வித் அவர் தமிழ் டிரவிடியன் கல்ச்சர் தென் த வெஸ்டர்ன் மெட்டீரியலிஸ்டிக் கல்ச்சர். Why do I say it goes very close with our Eastern and very much our Dravidian culture than the Western materialistic culture? You know the reason? I could not find an equivalent phrase for விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரிப்பது. I asked others also. In English, if you can find an ஈட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரிப்பது, yielding, giving in, adjusting, so many words I thought about. But the concept we get in விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரிப்பது, we don't find an equivalent in English. I don't find an equivalent in English. If you can find, you can share that with me. In the Bible, we don't read that phrase, vittu kodutha anusarippadu. But all through the Bible, especially in the New Testament, in the life of Jesus, we see this vittu kodutha anusarippadu in a greater way. And many a time in the families, especially in the husband and wife relationship, they use this phrase, விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போகணும், ஒருத்தருக்கு ஒருத்தர் விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போங்க. இஃப் தட் வைஃப் கொஞ்சம் விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போனால் இவ்வளோ பிரச்சனை வராது. ஒன் பேசிக் திங், அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங், கொஞ்சம் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ணி அவன் கொஞ்சம் விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போனால் அவள் சரியாயிடுவா. வி வெரி காமன்லி யூஸ் திஸ் ஃப்ரேஸ். என்னவ பட்டிமன்றம், வி கான்சன்ட்ரேட்டட் மோர் ஆன் த ஹஸ்பண்ட் அண்ட் ஒய்ஃப் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப். திஸ் விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போவது, இட்ஸ் அ கிரேட்டர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஃபார் த ஹஸ்பண்ட், ஆர் இட் இஸ் அ கிரேட்டர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி for the wife. So we had a debate on that and I got a lot of feedback even from abroad. They were waiting on their toes. We even with small arguments between husbands and wives, the pastor is going to say it's the responsibility of the husband or the responsibility of the wife. Our one family understood. After the Pattimandam, both of them knelt down. Holding their hands, they prayed that they should have this virtue, vittu koduthu anusarithu povathu. So there has been a request repeatedly that I should speak more on that. And this Friday when we had been for a house prayer meeting, there also this request came. So with the leading of the Lord, this morning I'm going to talk about the spiritual value, vittu koduthu anusarithu povathu. I'm not talking about husbands and wives, maybe between parents and children, maybe between the co-bonds, maybe in a church, a larger family. What does it actually mean by vittu koduthu anusarithu povathu? With your neighbors, co-tenants, in your work situation, what is vittu koduthu anusarithu povathu? It is a spiritual value. It is not yielding or giving in to pressure. Giving in doing something which we are not willing, but we succumb to pressure. That's giving in. Yielding also, almost similar to it. But vittu kodupadu, it is our voluntary action for a nobler cause. Even a young girl may yield to sexual temptation. So yielding is not right. Giving in because of pressure. But vittu kodupadu, it is a willing decision. I do it willingly for a noblest purpose, for peace, for the goodness of others. This is not for any bad thing, that you should understand this vittu koduthu. Similarly, anusaripadu, adjusting. Adjusting not because there is no other purpose, no, there is no other way. I adjust because there is no other way. But this anusaripadu, it is not I adjust because there is no other way. I adjust because it can be a blessing to others. It can bring goodness to others. Others could be blessed. I'm not doing anything wrong. I little bit bear with, I bear that weakness, their weakness. It is for their blessing. It is for their blessing. So again I go to those two Tamil words, vittu koduthu, anusaripadu. Vittu koduthu means something that I like, something that I enjoy. I give that up for somebody's blessing. To see briefly, Jesus was in heaven with the angels around him. But that Jesus, he gave up all his heavenly blessings, he came to the earth. Jesus who is in heaven, he is not doing anything wrong, he is not under pressure. It is written of me in the volumes of book. I am appointed for that purpose, the time came. So he gave up the pleasures of heaven. He came to the earth. He gave up heaven. He came to the earth. For the blessings of the mankind, it's not because he gets anything. The only one thing he gets, the joy of the travail of his soul. The satisfaction he gets because of the travail of his soul. Avar atma varuthathin balane karbar. And the sacrifice would be a joy when he could see the people getting saved, that's all. It's not a personal benefit. His joy is seeing the people blessed. For that he is willing to give up the heavenly abode. Anusarithal means in Tamil, giving up what you like, anusarithal, enduring what you don't like. What you don't like. So he endured the contradictions of sinners. Everything, false accusation, he endured. He was countered with the malefactors, he endured. He endured all pains, mockery, betrayal. He endured. It is not even the word endure gladly. I am come for this. I am come for this. He endured gladly. Again, for what? For the peace. The chastisement of our peace fell on him. So he suffered a lot that you and I could have peace. You and I could have peace. So we see in the life of Jesus how he had this character of vittukoduthu anusaripadu, giving up what you like, enduring what you don't like, for the purpose of somebody's good, somebody's blessing. Not because they pressurized him. You are yielding and giving up today, it's because of somebody's pressures. I do what I don't want to do because I'm pressurized to do it. It is not under pressure. It is a voluntary action. Na vittu kodukken. Na anusarichu poren. Not because it is under pressure. Na vittu kodutha anusarithu pona en husband rakshikapaduvaru, en kudumbam nalla irukum. என் ஹஸ்பண்ட் கெட்டு போகிறதுக்காக நான் விட்டு கொடுக்க வேண்டாம், இல்லை எனக்கு ஒரு லாபம் கிடைக்கும், எனக்கு அடி விழாது அப்படிங்கிறக்காக நான் விட்டு கொடுத்து போக வேண்டாம். த ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் திங், இந்த விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போகிறது, இட்ஸ் ஃபார் த பிளெஸ்ஸிங் ஆஃப் தி அதர் பர்சன். ஐ மேக் திஸ் சாக்ரிஃபைஸ் ஸோ தட் மை அவர் சில்ட்ரன் குட் பி பிளெஸ்ட். ஐ அட்ஜஸ்ட் வித் திஸ் கான்ட்ரரி சிச்சுவேஷன் that my children can learn well, that my children can have good education. I suffer. Then many parents have got the voluntarily, not under pressure. They give up some of their good for the well-being of their children. For the well-being of their children. விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரித்து போடுது. ஸோ ஹவ் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் திஸ் இன் த பைபிள், தட்ஸ் வெரி வெரி எசென்ஷியல் ஃபார் அவர் பர்சனல், அவர் ஃபேமிலி லைஃப், வெரி வெரி எசென்ஷியல், அவர் மினிஸ்ட்ரி. த பெஸ்ட் பேசேஜ் இஸ் ஃபவுண்ட் இன் ரோமன்ஸ். யூ கேன் மேக் அ நோட் ஆஃப் திஸ், இஸ் மோர் அ ஸ்டடி. If you study Romans chapter 12 to 15, even first part of 16, it's a very powerful passage for a Christian lifestyle. Is Romans chapter 12, 13, 14, 15 and part of 16. For a very, very high spiritual Christian lifestyle. God willing, we'll have a study on that. In Romans chapter 12, verse 1, it starts with our bodily holiness, how we should appear to the world. So we read in verse 1 and 2, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, I beg you by the mercies of God, that you are present, your body is a living sacrifice, your body, your external appearance. Because in those days they strongly believed, holiness is only inward. Holiness is only inward. So, Paul was suggesting with the Holy Spirit, that inward holiness should, must, ought to reflect on our bodies. In these last days, this study is very, very important. Our internal holiness must reflect on our bodies. I tell you a proposition, you can make a note of it if you want. If somebody is holy inside, if somebody is holy inside, he will surely be holy outside. He cannot be a supplanter, he cannot be a deceiver, that he is holy inside unholy outside. Can you understand? He cannot be a supplanter. He cannot be a fraud, deceiver. I am holy inside, only outside I am unholy. He is a fraud. Wear your heart on your sleeve. If you are holy inside, 100% you are holy outside. Okay. Proposition number 2. If you are unholy inside, you are unholy inside, you will be unholy outside. That's normal. You are unholy inside, you will be unholy outside. You will be holy inside, holy outside. You will be holy inside, unholy outside, it's not possible, then you are a fraud. Unholy inside, that reflects outside, you are unholy outside, normal. Somebody unholy inside, holy outside is a deceiver. You can put a holy appearance and inside you must be a ravening wolf. You must have a sheep clothes, but you may be a fox inside or a wolf inside. That's possible. But it is not possible, I'm holy inside, I am a sheep inside, only outside I am a wolf. It is not possible. It is not possible. Outside you may appear holy and inside you may be a thief. But you can't appear a saint inside, you can't be saint inside and appear a thief outside. It's impossible. Everything is not commutative in logic. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, therefore 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. But 3 minus 2 is equal to 1, it doesn't mean 2 minus 3 is also equal to 1. It's not commutative, that's logic. Holy inside, holy outside. Unholy inside, unholy outside. Unholy inside, holy outside. These three are possible. It is 100% impossible, holy inside, outside unholy. It's impossible. I'm not talking religion, I'm talking a pure logic. So he starts with the external holiness. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. How to keep my body holy and be not conformed to this world? Your conformity is not to the standard of this world fashions. Fashions of the world pass away. So don't take the world fashions as a standard, don't conform to that. But be ye transformed, changed. Let your form be changed. By the renewing of your mind. Your mind is renewed. Everything is your mindset. So your hairstyle, your adornment, your dress, your pedicure, manicure, everything. By the transforming of your mind, that you may prove what is that good, what is that acceptable, what is that perfect will of God. With that he starts how we should have our life on this earth. He speaks about a very high spiritual standard. In chapter 13, he talks about love. He talks about putting on the weapons of light. And he goes to chapter, in the same chapter 13, again he ends with the physical holiness. In verse 14, chapter 13. But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. There is lust in the flesh. What is the lust in the flesh? Ullahatin asi, mamsatin ichi, jivanatin peru. It's in us. It's in us. But don't maintain your body that can feed the lust in you. The lust in you. So in chapters 12 and 13, he talks about a personal lifestyle. With that he goes to chapter 14. From chapter 14, 15 and 16, he talks about our high values in interpersonal relationships. Interpersonal relationships. When he talks about very high spiritual standards in chapter 12 and 13, and he says that with that spiritual standard, you must know how to live with others. With that high spiritual standard, you must know how to live with others. When we become very spiritual, many a time we become a misfit to live with others. That's a big problem. When we become very spiritual, hyper-spiritual, we become too spiritual to live in with others. That's why they go for Thuravaram, monastery. They leave their families. They leave their work situations. They want to be alone. When they become spiritual, one of the dangers, they don't know how to maintain their interpersonal relationship. So in chapter 14, 15, 16, he focuses with high spiritual value how we should have interpersonal relationship. So in verse 1, chapter 14, he says, him that is weak in the faith, receive. Faith here doesn't talk about the faith in Jesus Christ. Faith talks about Christian lifestyle. Christian lifestyle. He that is weak in the Christian lifestyle, receive him. Say the Christian lifestyle. We all are in different types. Say maintaining the body or not providing room for the lust interest of the flesh. I just take gents here. So somebody has got clean shave, somebody has got French beard, somebody has got mustache. Different types. White shirt, color shirt, full sleeves, half sleeves. Thank God, no one with no sleeves. Different types of dress. But the he teaches, sacrifice your body a living sacrifice. Don't maintain your body a provision to fulfill the lust in you. Don't conform to the fashions of the world. It's a teaching for me. It is a teaching for Simon. It is a teaching for Salman. So outwardly we see the dress. Salman, goody goody boy in white and white. Simon, half white, half... What is this? Who is the better holy person? It doesn't mean we should change like somebody else. But when you maintain a high spiritual standard, receive others as they are. It is not accepting their standard. It is not accepting their weak faith. Jesus became man not to live like a man. He became a man to make us gods. So in the interpersonal relationship, You don't have mustache, so don't condemn others with mustache. Receive them. You wear white, it's good. This is where some people, they stumble with my balanced teaching. They stumble that there are some believers we are used in the church. We had a seminar on jewels. What 400 people attended. And almost every volunteer was wearing jewels. So one pastor asked, "Your pastor is speaking so strong against jewels, but you all are wearing jewels." So one sister immediately replied, "Our pastor is against wearing jewels, it's not against the person who is wearing jewels." Even today, we desire, we pray that you all should be like we are. You should be more holy in your spirit, soul and body, and more fervent ministry than the ministry we are doing. As Paul said, except for the suffering we have. That's my desire. We pray for our family members, we pray for our church. But we receive others who don't walk in the same dedication or commitment or standard. We receive them. This is the balanced teaching. So individually you also do it for your interpersonal relationship. You maintain a high standard, spiritual standard. He that is holy, let him be holy still. He that is holy, let him be holy still. Holy still. See, I love to wear a thick dress, a suit for Sunday service. Generally from April middle to June middle, here we didn't have AC also, I wear this dress. But the summer has not yet left, so I am continuing with the shirt. So I know why I am wearing it. I don't say this is holy or that is holy. So you maintain a standard and try to raise them, but accept others, those who got they got weakness in their Christian lifestyle. So he says, him that is weak in the faith, a Christian walk, receive ye, but not doubtful disputations. Receive him. Don't stir up arguments on that. Don't stir up arguments on that. And verse 7, "For none of us liveth to himself, and no man dieth to himself," in a general way, except martyrs. I die because death comes. You die because death comes. You are not going to die for Robert Simon's sake, and Robert Simon is not going to die for your sake. They are martyrs. If that is so, I live in a general way, not for your sake, and you live not for my sake. It's a general way. So don't condemn others. You live for your sake, they live for their sake. In verse 8, "For whether we live unto the Lord. Whether we die unto the Lord." So in a spiritual way, if you die, die for the sake of the Lord. If that is so, you live for the sake of the Lord. Combing your hair, trimming your eyebrows, making up your face, dressing up, don't do it for yourself. Don't do it for yourself. Your lifestyle, for the Lord. For the Lord. That's the will of God. So whether you live unto God, whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live therefore or die, we are the Lord's. Verse 10. But why dost thou judge thy brother? Why do you judge them? Or why dost thou set at naught thy brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. We all shall stand with dirty shirt, with white pants, white shirt, with color shirt, white pants. We all will judge before Him. We all will stand before Him. Can somebody say, because I am wearing white and white, I am already judged, I will go to heaven? Will I not stand before God? Will my dress make me worthy to go to God, heaven? We all will stand before God. So verse 17 he says, for the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Verse 19, therefore follow after things which make for peace, and things wherewith one may edify another. So he says, in the your external holiness, your internal holiness is very, very important. But when you live with others, in the interpersonal relationship, is not judging others, live for the peace. Live for the edifying of others. Edifying your wife. Edifying your children. Edifying your husband. For the edification of your parents-in-law. For the edification of your grandchildren. For the peace in the family. For the peace with the neighbors. For the peace in a work situation, in the ministry, in the church. What can I do that there can be peace? I don't want to have mustache. I want to commit my body as sacrifice. But I receive somebody with mustache. I don't judge them. I don't live for him, he doesn't live for me. I live for the glory of the Lord, I want him to live for the glory of the Lord. But the purpose in me is not just my physical holiness, the purpose in me is for peace, joy, righteousness. That is bringing kingdom on the earth. Bringing kingdom on the earth. So with this he goes to chapter 15, verse 1. We then, in the interpersonal relationship, we then that are strong, spiritually strong. Chapter 12 and 13. Talks about a very high spiritual living standard, and I accept it. And we that are strong, Paul includes himself, we that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak. So who are the weak? Who are the weak? Are they non-Christians? They may be non-Christians. Are our brethren, our relatives, our husband, our wife, our children, our parents-in-law, our co-born, who are unable to accept, who are unable to measure up to the high spiritual standard, both physical and external and internal, they are unable to accept that spiritual standard. So he says, we that are strong, we that are accepted a high spiritual value of lifestyle, bear the infirmities of the weak. That is, vittu kodutthu anusarithu povathu. Bear the infirmities of the weak and not to please ourselves. Not to please ourselves. Accept the infirmities of those who are weak. Verse 2. Let every one of us please his neighbor for his good to edification. So hear this, vittu kudutha anusarithu povathu, not because of my pressure. Because na vittu kudutha anusarithu povathu, avanukku rakshippa irukkum. Avan naalikku maaranum. See, I just go back to the jewelry. So Romans 12:1, I understand, I should keep my body a holy sacrifice unto the Lord, acceptable, pleasing. I don't want to keep my body as an idol. But I accept somebody who doesn't have that revelation and show love to him. It is not that I am compromising and wearing jewels with my love, with my patience, with me waiting patiently, talking to that person. One day that person can be like me. Hallelujah. That is the secret. Vittu kodutha anusarithu povathu, it is not for me to be like that person. My only desire to make that person like me. I bear. I accept. I receive. The goal is the same higher value. That's why in verse 2 it's very beautiful. Let every one of us please his neighbor. So I please Simon if I am strong. Why? For his good to edification. Because I please Simon, Simon should not become bad to us. Okay, Simon, I do everything. Oh, nothing wrong in it, Simon. Oh, no problem, Simon. You come anytime. I know you are busy, Simon. Yesterday also, I was calling these volunteers and saying, you must be here at 7:30. For some of you, it is very difficult to come at 8 o'clock. But these volunteers come here at 7:30. I reach here at 7:35. Before me there are many of the volunteers. So my love to him is not to say, Simon, he is paying tithes. He is not a paid person. He pays tithe. I don't want to hurt him. I want to love him. I don't want to miss that tithe. Rubbish. Nonsense. I love him. I receive him. I yield to him because my desire that it is for his edification. He should be able to grow. He should be able to change like me. My dear brother, my dear sister. So he says very carefully, let every one of us please his neighbor. Adjust with your neighbor. Give unto your neighbor. What's the purpose? For his good to edification. That he could be edified, that he could also be able to become strong as you are strong. So verse 3, For even Christ pleased not himself. It was not the pleasure for Jesus to come out of heaven. It's not the pleasure for Jesus to die on the cross. So he was not trying to please him. As it is written, the reproaches of him that reproached thee fell on me. I'll explain that later. Verse 4. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. I'll explain these things later. Now the God of patience and consolation grant you to be like-minded one toward another according to Christ Jesus. So on, so forth. Now we go to the main topic. How is it possible? Vittu kudutha anusarithu povathu. Can I just go on yielding myself? How long I should yield? This is not just a magic wand. With all divine help, I tell you, three things are very, very important in our mindset. Three things are very, very important for our mindset. Number one, a desire to live for others. This is why I said in the Western philosophy, it is materialistic theory, living for my right. Especially from the French Revolution, the laborers fighting for their right. The courts are there to protect my rights. The boss, he wants his rights to be protected. So today our mindset, my right must be protected. Why we got so many laws? It is to protect my right. So husband and wife relationship, this is my right. Wife says it is my right. Husband says it is my right. That's why they are unable to live together when their interests contradict. Everybody is interested in his right, her right. This is a materialistic viewpoint, my right. The social consciousness, social awareness is pushed back to personal interests. I first. You next. My dear brother, my dear sister, that's first. Somebody said, in life, if you want to smile, I must be in the center. If the whole world is laugh at me, you must be at the center. If I keep you at the center, everybody will laugh at me. As long as I keep I in the middle, I can be happy. I can always smile. My dear, it's just only a word game. But if you have got a lifestyle, I live for others. Maybe very difficult. I live for my family. I live for ministry. The highest goal, I live for God's purpose. Whether as a husband, a wife, or a child, or an officer, or a peon, whatever, I live for God's purpose. As a chartered accountant, somebody working in the church, somebody working elsewhere, doing business, my very existence is for God's purpose. Otherwise, I got no business to live. I live for God's purpose. If you have got that high value, living for others, living for God's purpose, that helps someone have the grace to vittu kodutha anusarithu porathu. Romans chapter 15 verse, let every one of us please his neighbor for his good to edification. 1 Corinthians 10:24. Let no man seek his own, but every man another's well-being. Let every mother-in-law, I'll put it like this, let no mother-in-law seek her own if she is a Christian. Let no mother-in-law seek her own. If you are a Christian, are you a Christian mother-in-law? Don't seek for your own. But every Christian mother-in-law seek the well-being of your daughter-in-law. Otherwise, you are not fit to be a Christian. Every Christian daughter-in-law, don't seek for your well-being, but every Christian daughter-in-law seek for the well-being of your mother-in-law. Put it like that. Otherwise, you are not fit to be a Christian. So let no man, whether mother-in-law, son-in-law, daughter-in-law, father, the son, akka, annan, thambi, whatever the relationship may be, in your interpersonal relationship, if you are a strong person, you don't seek your own. But at the same time, seek the well-being of other person. That's the Bible says. Same 1 Corinthians 10, chapter 10, verse 33. Even as I please all men in all things, not seeking my own profit. I need this dress. I need new sari for Christmas. I don't know whether my husband will get or my daughter-in-law will get or my children get. I need a new sari. I need a new sari. I should buy this for my daughter. I don't worry whether my daughter-in-law gets this or not. I want to buy this for my daughter. Rubbish. Third-rate rubbish. Paul says, even I please all men in all things, not seeking my own profit, but the profit of many. Literally, one brother wept with me, wept. He came and wept to me. He had a Deepavali loan sanctioned, 25,000 rupees or something, credit loan sanctioned. Literally, he came and wept. His wife bought some two saris or three saris and some pillow, bed sheet, etc. And one daughter at that time, a small girl, a frock, some 500, 600 rupees, 25,000 credit limit exhausted, he said. She didn't even ask me whether I wanted to buy a shirt. Can she be a Christian? She has got a Christian name. She didn't even ask me whether I want a shirt. 25,000 rupees for his salary, a credit loan is sanctioned. The credit loan is sanctioned for Deepavali purchase. 25,000 rupees. Mostly she bought saris, etc. Maybe a bedspread or something for the family. And a frock for their daughter. Some 500, 600 rupees. My dear brother, my dear sister, if you are a Christian, even as I please all men, all things, not seeking my own, but the profit of many. I get this sari or not, let my daughter-in-law have one. My dear brother, my dear sister, the real Tamil culture, ஒரு சிலையை கூட அழகுபடுத்தி ரசிப்பது. நான் உடுத்தி கண்ணாடிக்கு முன்னால் இருந்து ரசிப்பது மெட்டீரியலிசம். என் கண்ணுக்கு முன்னால் ஒரு பொம்மைக்கு நல்ல துணி போட்டு ரசிப்பது நம்முடைய கலாச்சாரம். அதனால தான் செலை செஞ்சு செலை செஞ்சு எனக்கு நல்ல புடவை போட்டு பார்த்து ரசிக்கிறேன், தரிசிக்கிறேன். இன்னொரு ஃபிலாசபி பிஹைண்ட் இட், சி அதர்ஸ் ஹவு தே ஆர் ட்ரெஸ்ட், யுவர் ஃபேமிலி பீப்புள், கிவ் டு தேம், என்ஜாய் தேர் ப்ராஃபிட், பி ஹாப்பி, த ரியல் ஹாப்பினஸ் வென் யூ சி தே ஆர் பிளஸ்ட். தட்ஸ் எ கிறிஸ்டியன் வேல்யூ. I can go on and on. Chapter, Philippians chapter 2 verse 4. Look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. It's all with many people. They want to buy a branded shirt. They want to have a good car. He wants all comforts. As if they are in a hotel. As soon as we just press the bell, a room boy comes. As soon as he calls, wife should bring coffee, daughter should bring water, the food should be on the table, there must be a good buffet spread. Rubbish. That's not family. That's not family. I'm sorry for using that word rubbish, but I mean it. That's not family. Just to think that as soon as I ring the bell, immediately she should come and say, yes sir, what do you want sir? My dear brother, my dear sister, probably in a hotel you spend less than what you spend in a family, you get all this treatment. You get all this treatment. For less, what you spend for your family, you can spend even in a hotel and get this treatment. There will be two or three yes sirs you'll hear. My dear brother, my dear sister, but if you are a gentleman, if you are a Christian, look not at the things of you, my daughter, my son, my pastor, my church, my country, my fellow citizen, another human being. My dear brother, my dear sister, somebody doesn't get a drop of water, I think I don't have a right to drink the second tumbler of water. Looking for others' comfort. It's not only son-in-law, daughter-in-law, mother-in-law, husband, wife, neighbor, fellow citizen. So vittu kodutha anusarithu povathu basically possible only when you have this high value, I am living for others. I put it in a simpler way. Naa uduthi uduthi kannadil enna paakkirathu makeup. Oru selaiyai uduthi naa poi paarkirathu tholugai. Puridha? ஒரு சிலையை உடுத்தி நான் போய் பார்ப்பது தொழுகை, என்னை உடுத்தி கண்ணாடியிலே நான் பார்ப்பது மேக்கப். தட் இஸ் அவர் கல்ச்சர். சி ஹவ் யுவர் மதர் இன் லா இஸ் பிளஸ்ட், ஆர் ஃபாதர் இன் லா பிளஸ்ட், யுவர் டாக்டர் இன் லா பிளஸ்ட், ஹவ் யுவர் ஹஸ்பண்ட்ஸ் ஃபேமிலி, ஒய்ஃப்ஸ் ஃபேமிலி, தே ஆர் பிளஸ்ட், யுவர் நேபர்ஸ். தட்ஸ் த கிறிஸ்டியன் லைஃப். இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஸ்ட்ராங். Chapter 12 and 7, 13, put on the weapons of light, be filled with love, have a physical holiness. Yes, it's very good. Chapter 14, 15, if you are strong, then think about others. A personal commitment for others' sake. Number two, a life of sacrifice. Dhyaham. In Tamil Bible we use the word bali, but I love the word thyagam, a joy in becoming sacrifice. When you sacrifice, you can't take it back. You give an offering, you can't take it back. So you lose that permanently, that is called sacrifice. not just giving up, losing permanently, but finding a joy in sacrifice. That's the martyrdom. Many people lose their life for the sake of their country, sake of the language, sake of their family. We all call them Dyagigal. They sacrifice their life. But the whole world will say, Anagana Paityama, Mutal Tanama, Empo Nerchikra, Niam Baliagra. Say if a daughter-in-law wants to sacrifice her life for that family, she is willing to die for that family, what her friends will say? Anagana Paityama. Anagana Talayana Tapri and the Chaganama. One of the right trick. Fight for your right. Ask a portion in their property. Ask for sustenance, allowance. Come out. You got a right. You can marry somebody else. Why do you suffer like that? She wants to become a martyr in that family. What her mother, father will say? Will they say, die there? Don't be mad. அப்படிலாம் நீ போய் சாகணுங்கிறது உன் தலையெழுத்து இல்லை. ஸோ தே டோன்ட் தேர் டாட்டர், தே டோன்ட் வாண்ட் தேர் ஃப்ரெண்ட் டு பிகம் அ மார்ட்டர். த சேம் திங் வித் மென். மார்ட்டர் இஸ் அ வெரி ஹை ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லைஃப் ஸ்டைல். தி வேர்ல்ட் வில் நாட் அக்செப்ட். தி வேர்ல்ட் வில் நாட் அக்செப்ட். பட் தே ஃபைண்ட் அ ஜாய் இன் சாக்ரிஃபைஸ். It's not only sacrificing life, sacrificing some comfort, and you find a joy in it. And that sacrifice you willingly do, that you should not forget, it is to their his edification. It's not to fulfill his lust. It's not out of my fear. I willingly, gladly make a sacrifice with a design that my sacrifice will good to edify him. It's good to edify him. That will make him stronger. I die on the cross that this wicked Robert can go to heaven. I sacrifice because there is no other way. No. I die on the cross, Jesus says, that Robert can go to heaven. I'm willing to make that sacrifice. For his purpose, for his blessing. So sacrifice is not under pressure, it should be under pleasure. So here also I show you a few verses, a couple of verses, and go ahead. In Romans 15:3, Jesus says, for even Christ pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of them that reproached God. The reproaches of them that reproached God. They reproach, என்ன ஆண்டவர் எங்களை படைச்சு ஏன் படைச்சார், ஏன் இப்படி பாவத்தில் இருக்கோம், ஏன் இப்படி கஷ்டப்படுறோம், எங்களுக்கு ஏன் வியாதி, எங்களுக்கு ஏன் பலவீனம். In one commentator says, people spitting on God, angry, spitting on God. The reproaches of them that reproached God, Jesus came in between, accept the spit on his face. God wants to scourge these people for all the evil they are doing. God is Almighty, King of Kings. He takes the whip. He wants to scourge the people. Jesus showed his back. That is sacrifice. People spitting on God, he showed his face. God wanted to scourge the people, he took the scourge. Hallelujah, how beautiful. He came in between. That is sacrifice. In Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2 it says, look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before us, before him, endured the cross. That is a joy in martyrdom. Others cannot accept. Willingly நான் விட்டு கொடுத்து அனுசரிக்கிறேன். தேர்ஸ் அ ஜாய் இன் இட், நாட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரெஷர், பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ளஷர், பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த ஜாய் தட் வாஸ் செட் பிஃபோர் ஹிம், என்டியூர் த க்ராஸ் டிஸ்பைசிங் த ஷேம். இது என்னடா செப்போடா ஷேம், ஹி டிஸ்பைஸ் த ஷேம், ஹி புட் த ஷேம் டு ஷேம், ஹி புட் த ஷேம் டு ஷேம், அண்ட் இஸ் செட் டவுன் அட் த ரைட் ஹேண்ட் ஆஃப் த த்ரோன் ஆஃப் காட். Matthew chapter 20:28, Jesus said, even as the Son of Man came to give his life a ransom for many. Can we just imagine like that? I am gone there, I am come for the ministry, to give my life for the people. They call us at odd times. Sometimes it's very interesting, they start with, ஃபஸ்ட்டு தொந்தரவு பண்ணுறோன்னு நினைக்காதீங்க, அவங்களுக்கே தெரியும் தொந்தரவு பண்ணுறோம். நானாலும் தே ஃபைன் நோ ஆர் ஆல்டர்னேட்டிவ் தென் காலிங் எஸ். இந்த ஆட் அவரில் ஃபோன் பண்ணுறோன்னு நினைக்காதீங்க பாஸ்டர். மை டியர் பிரதர், மை டியர் சிஸ்டர், வி கேம் ஃபார் திஸ் பர்பஸ். தேர் மே பி டெஸ்டிங் டைம்ஸ். ஜஸ்ட் ஐ கிவ் திஸ் ஒன் ஸ்மால் இல்லஸ்ட்ரேஷன், ஐ கேட் அ லாட் மோர் டு கன் டூ, பட் ஐ ட்ரை டு ஃபினிஷ் இட். மை டியர் பிரதர், மை டியர் சிஸ்டர், there are few occasions that I have worked without a wink of sleep, at least two occasions I think, without a wink of sleep for 72 hours, certainly one occasion. There are a few occasions without a wink of sleep for 48 hours, 36 many, all night prayer, ministry, school work, ministry, school work, etc. Two all-night prayers. So I would not have slept. I might have gone to school. It's grace. It's a, I don't advise that could spoil the body. Okay. Once like that, nearly 48 hours, two nights, two days with no sleep. And the third night, I loved to sleep, I lusted to sleep. But I didn't have strength to sleep. I was just rolling on the body, my bed. In those days it was a landline, close to my bed. Around 11:15 I was getting sleep. I was getting sleep, phone rang. Oh yes, I took the phone. Wrong number. I kept the phone down. Again, after a few minutes, the phone. I know it was the wrong number. But I could not sleep, I was not taking the phone. Again it was ringing. Again it was ringing. So it should not be from some believer. So again I took the phone. One poor boy, small boy, one poor boy. Amma is very sick, admitted in the hospital. And with cry he says, please come. They got no father, no many relatives, small two children, a boy and a girl. So the boy was weeping and sobbing. Amma is in the hospital. Where? In Chetpat. And every day, the yarakam kuda avakilla thookam nana kekkuren. 12:15, I got up, I don't know what to do. I went to take my car. Sister said, "Ni in the condition that don't take the car. You take a taxi and go." So I booked for a taxi. In those days, this travels. I booked for a travel car. It came around 12:30, 12:45. I went to Chetpat Hospital. She was in drips and all. The boy was standing and weeping. And the doctor said, I met the doctor, no, the condition is serious, we can't say anything. I went to that room. Immediately sister said, I am all right, take everything, my pastor is coming, I am all right. I was also a little skeptical, no, wait. They said, no, we can't, you are in observation, the tube here, that tube there, everything she wanted to remove. She said, I am all right. The nurse said, okay, she was so serious and she has become all right. She became all right, that was another problem. She became all right, she said, Pastor, in the middle of the room. She became all right. She said, Pastor, in a vitla, vuttrunga. So from the hospital, with her two children, the house was at Mylapore at that time. From Chetpat we went all the way to Mylapore. Left her, coming back. When I was crossing Chetpat bridge, literally I remembered it. When I was crossing, they just looked at that hospital, Mehta Hospital. When I was crossing at the Chetpat bridge, I said, Andavare Yarakailiya. I heard a voice. I called you for this purpose. Idarkagave unnai alaithe. That's our dear sister Papi Mary. I started with this in the ministry. I mean, this is interesting. We enjoy. The pain is there. What do you mean by I started this with the ministry? I finished 26 days, continual preaching. Every day 3 messages. One day maximum I have preached 8 messages. Just imagine 26 days. At an average you take 3 messages. About 100 messages I have preached continuously. That's all the voice. No voice is coming. With all those exertion, night travel from Kanyakumari, had a wash, went to Pastor Sundaram around 7 o'clock. Meeting every bar and say, that's all I could talk. Rumba tired acting, other character. He asked me a question. It was the first time we had come for the ministry. Somebody Kasi Modi Tharima. Tharayadu Pastor. The Junin or Ponnu Arima Tharima. Tharayadu Pastor. Bring the driver ke. The Junin Vati Kura Kuttu Po. There is itana uliya karanga irukkanga. En thonde paathu kuda andha manushanukku irakkam illaya. We know we came for that purpose. That's my first house visitation when I came for the ministry. In 1985, it was Sister June's house. Don was shorter than this table at that time. I remember Don very well. They are with us, a great blessing today. So there is a joy in these pains. So real sacrifice is not enduring suffering under pressure. That's why I said we don't have an English word for this. Enduring pains for the joy that is kept before us. For the joy that is kept before us. Probably we never had a very close relationship with Sister June and the family when we were in ACA. When we started this ministry, Carmel, Sister June didn't know that we had started a ministry, we didn't tell her. We know them as a family. But it is divine purpose. She came all the way to Annanagar. Till this day in our ministry they are a blessing. Why do I say this? So sacrifice is different. In Christian person you find joy in accepting that pains. You know, just I read Ephesians chapter 5 verse 2. And walk in love. How can we walk in love? As Christ also hath loved us and hath given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savour. Offer yourself. That is walking in love. As a sacrifice, as an offering. Kanikeyaga, baliyaga, dyagama. And how is it possible to have this vittukoduthu anusaripade, the third one, the commitment. The commitment. In Romans 15:7, wherefore receive ye one another as Christ also received us to the glory of God. I endure. Receive ye means vittukoduthu anusaripade. for the glory of God. I committed for the glory of God. Somebody said, in the pillengalukkaga na vaalven. Enna kashtam vandhalum seri, in the pillengalukkaga na vaalven. So as a Christian we say, enna kashtam vandhalum seri, deva naama mahime padradhukkaga na vaalven. In verse 4, for whatsoever things were written aforetime, were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. I was just 22 years when I got saved. Just a few weeks since I got saved. One day my akka, she wanted me to buy something from a particular place. We called it Moolakada, not this Moolakada. Moola Road. So it may be from here, little closer to Kelly's, maybe Kelly's. So I went all the way walking down to Kelly's, I bought that and came. A Christian home. I was baptized. I was the only person baptized in the family. Baptized, received the Holy Spirit and all. Not that I've entered in, my another akka told, "Ayyo, Rabi, poi vaangittu vandirupa." It is again to the same Moola Road. Again to the same Kelly's. I walked all the way to the Kelly's. I bought that and came back. Sooner than I stepped in, it was a testing time. My mother said, "Ayyo, na idu maranditen poi vaangittu." It might be somewhere Princeton, same route. A few meters before Moola Road. I just told my mother, "Na rendu varam poi vandutan appame neenga sollirukkalame. அப்படின்னு சொன்னோடனே எங்கள் அக்கா என்கிட்ட சொன்னாங்க, "நீ என்ன ரட்சிக்கப்பட்டு ஞானஸ்தானம் எடுத்திருக்க, பைபிள் என்ன சொல்லியிருக்கு, உன்னை 1 மைல் தூரம் போக பலவந்தம் பண்ணினால் நீ 2 மைல் தூரம் போக ஆயத்தமாக இருக்கணும், நாங்கள் உன்னை 3 தடவை கரைக்கு அனுப்புனா நீ 6 தடவை போக ஆயத்தமாக இருக்கணும், இதுதான் கிறிஸ்டியானிட்டி, யுவர் மைண்ட் செட், கமிட்மெண்ட் டு கிறிஸ்டியன் வேல்யூஸ்." Literally I ran. I said, "I praise God, I thank my sister. You showed me a Bible verse. I learned that verse. I'm not exaggerating. For the glory of God, I tell you." I literally ran. Today I am a witness to my sisters. My sisters know. Her tummy wants to keep the values of the Bible. "Yella enda rakshikapatta enna pranniya appadina thitta mudiyadhu." Because I submitted not to my sisters, to the word of God. She showed me a word of God. "Nee vanna 1 mile thooram pochanna nee 2 mile thooram poga right ready a irukano. Vanna naanga 3 thara kadaikku enna panna nee 6 tharam poga ready a irukano." Amma paathu yema modhale solla koodadhan kekka koodadhu. Till this day, I never, even in my ministry, in my work spot, I was willing to go that extra mile. Because that's the Bible says. Not for preaching, sister. Brother, not for preaching. Children, not for preaching. I learned that lesson, that commitment to the word of God. In verse 5, now the good practice and consolation grant you to be like-minded one toward another according to Christ Jesus. How is it possible? Verse 6. That you may with one mind and one mouth glorify God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. All these things are possible because you want to live as it is written. For the glory of God, God's name to be blasphemed. Let come what may. God's name should not be blasphemed. It's my family, my own sisters, But because of me, God's name should not be blasphemed. It is written of me. If you have somebody compels you to go for 1 mile, you must be ready to go for 2 miles. It is written for me. It is written for you. If you are not willing to go for that extra mile, that is not written for you, that's written for somebody else. You tear that page and put it in fire. If you don't want to walk according to the Beatitudes, turn all those pages, put it in fire, that will be better for you than walking contrary to that. Then walking contrary to that, tear those pages. No, I can't walk accordingly, put it in fire. Because it is not for you. You can't walk like that. I believe it is for me, I want to walk like that. These three characters, a desire to live for others, getting joy in becoming ourselves a sacrifice, and commitment to the word of God, then only vittu kuduthu anusarithu povathu possible. Then it is whose responsibility? In verse 1, chapter 15, it's very simple. One who is strong, spiritually strong. If you are spiritually strong, you'll have the desire to live for others. If you are spiritually strong, you'll get joy in becoming a sacrifice. If you are spiritually strong, you'll have a commitment for the word of God to become your life. You'll have a commitment for Jesus' teachings. Then vittu kuduthu anusarithu porathu, it will become very simple and easy in your life. Shall we just pray? The Spirit of the Lord has spoken to the church. Dear Father God, help us to be successful in our interpersonal relationship, O Lord. He that is strong in you, O Lord, or he that professes, as she that professes that she is a Christian, help him, help her, help us have the spiritual values, O Lord, to live for others, to get joy in becoming a sacrifice, and a deep commitment to your word. It is written of me. It is written for me, for my sake. I should commit to that word, O Lord. Bless your people. Let our interpersonal relationship be very successful, that we would be able to win others, O Lord. We thank you, we praise you, we worship you. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray. Amen.